You know, whether the cause is limitless hubris or it's some innate inability to check their perverse authoritarian excitement, politicians and bureaucrats sometimes let slip their black-as-midnight plans to attack our liberty and hurt us. In 2019, Joe Biden did precisely that when he openly stated he would end fossil fuel. And using the softer but meaning the same thing term phase out, he repeatedly reiterated the threat, pointing to 2050 as his date for the end, and telling listeners,
no more drilling.
Yet Jennifer Granholm, the perpetually sanctimonious, Cheshire-Cat-grinning former governor of Michigan, whom Biden picked to fill the unconstitutional Secretary of Energy slot in his insulting administration, well, Friday, she first tried to avoid acknowledging Biden's statements, and then she couldn't stop herself from essentially, you got it, confirming precisely the energy attack plan. Hi, everyone. I'm Gardner Goldsmith for MRCTV. You know, appearing like a sardonic court jester on CNBC's Squawk Box, Granholm seemed to be there in order to defend or perhaps promote a new administration move to block further liquefied natural gas export slots at U.S. ports, something that anyone familiar with freedom or the United States Constitution knows is neither a moral position nor a constitutional power granted to the feds, and is something that will harm U.S. energy businesses seeking affordable storage and shipment opportunities for their product. But as host Joe Kernan brought up Biden's record of rhetorical threats and policy strangulation of petrochemical exploration, recovery, refining, and transport, Granholm appeared to take issue with Kernan's recitation of the facts.
Chair, your comments on our show, and I know we have a business audience, and I'm sure that you wouldn't cater your comments to that, but they're very measured and you know, you bring up a lot of reasons other than climate change for why you're doing this. But if you look at the way the president's selling it, and he basically said, you know, that this is the an attempt to tackle the existential crisis of our time. And activists are hailing the decision as a landmark crisis that shows that industries will no longer just get a blank okay to proceed with building oil and gas products. A powerful statement. We can no longer allow these industries to continue operating. And that harkens back to President Biden's campaign vow to put the fossil fuel business out of business. And he said that, he said, read my lips, we will put fossil fuels out of business.
Ever the politician, and perhaps well aware that in a pseudo-denial of the facts, she needs to give herself some room for plausible deniability of her own deception, Jennifer Granholm didn't say Biden had never said what we all know he stated. Instead, she claimed,
I did not hear him say that.
Of course, it's possible that Jennifer Granholm has some hearing problems. Perhaps she's been a regular at numerous music festivals, or perhaps her internal monologue is so loud she just doesn't hear much beyond her own self-praise. But of course, as I noted earlier, the information is readily available. Biden's flip and fatuous fascist statements are on video. Fox News' Alexander Hall writes, quote, the video can be seen of then candidate Biden on the campaign trail in 2019 after a New Hampshire environmental activist questioned him for accepting donations from the co-founder of a liquefied natural gas firm.
But I want you to look in my eyes. I guarantee you, we're going to end fossil fuel.
Heck, within days of entering office, Biden engaged in so many so-called executive actions to attack petrochemical energy suppliers and us consumers that even a French news agency took notice, observing that on day one, Biden threw U.S. energy policy back on the anti-petrochemical path of the non-treaty, non-binding, non-law, anti-freedom, so-called Paris Climate Accord, shut down drilling in the Gulf of Mexico, mandated a pause on new drilling leases in Alaska, and canceled the Keystone XL pipeline. Was Jennifer Granholm so monumentally busy she missed all of that? Was she too stressed trying to handle the stock options she got from electric bus maker Proterra after she, of course, sat on their board, which in turn came after she helped Proterra get millions in federal subsidies when she was Michigan governor? Yeah, it's such a shame that she was so out of the loop. She might have noticed what Biden said. Well, yeah, you know, perhaps she was just too busy. Perhaps she was too busy restricting our light bulb choices or threatening gas stove makers. Or perhaps she actually was aware of Biden's threats and merely wanted to deflect while on CNBC. After all, she ended up confirming precisely what Kernan observed. She offered the confirmation in soft language, saying there has to be a managed transition. But of course, that's not you managing what you want. That's the government managing our lives with edicts, force, pork subsidies of things like Proterra, which, by the way, filed for bankruptcy shortly after Granholm sold her stock for nearly $2 million. Yes, and of course, it has to include extended international trips for climate summits from those Washington politicians and bureaucrats, those summits that will inject all of their insufferable rhetoric and lies even further into the business of our lives. This is the same Jennifer Granholm who simply can't grasp that the private market is not embracing electric vehicle sales. In fact, automakers worldwide have stepped away from EV plans like lost hikers who've backed away from the edge of a dangerous cliff. Is it possible that Ms. Granholm's tonal difference can't hide the reality that Biden has telegraphed so many times? Is it possible that when Biden says no more drilling and his actions indicate a profound antipathy to our freedom to get energy, that he actually means what he says? And is it possible that a Bidenista like Jennifer Granholm can cease the lame wordplay and just admit what they're doing to us? The reality of it all is rushing towards us like a train, and they have shown absolutely no sign of changing their plans. They want to destroy the petrochemical energy market and destroy our economics and our livelihoods and our plans for the future as well. In fact, it comes part and parcel with their attempts ongoing to destroy what's left of our freedom. Thanks for watching, one and all. Please like and subscribe. Find us on Rumble, where they don't censor us. We are still on YouTube. The MRCTV pages on both are hopping. Check them out. And please share these videos with friends, neighbors, loved ones, coworkers, any folks you think might be interested in this kind of information and being warned about this, to push back against these fatuous criminal minds and ideas. You can also find us inside Facebook. And of course, please visit mrctv.org. That's mrctv.org, where you can find out what the whole team is doing. We're on TikTok, we're on Instagram, and on Twitter/X. And on Twitter/X, I am at Gard Goldsmith, G-A-R-D Goldsmith. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. Remember, mrctv.org. When you're there, please consider donating to the Media Research Center. It always helps out. For MRCTV, I'm Gardner Goldsmith.